Hi everyone, welcome to the 13th and for now final video for the quantitative methods course. In this video I'll talk about how to do mediation in nonlinear models. And this is really quite advanced statistics and also not something I expect you to do for any of the assignments. But still it's something that some of you might need to do for your thesis, even though it's very advanced. And as such I do want to show how to do it correctly. Let's first load up the data that we've had before. And one complication that's unique to mediation in nonlinear models is that you are working with multiple equations. So for any mediation models like the ones we've seen before, so for the simple mediation model, there are two equations. The first being with the outcome variable, but the other one is the one to the mediating variable. So where before we've seen, for example, cash on acquisitions and also cash and acquisitions on the outcome variable. So this is two equations, two outcome variables in a sense, acquisitions and gross profits. And each can be, in theory, nonlinear. So one could be a count and the other one could be a dummy. One could be just a regular continuous variable, the other one could be a dummy. Both could be dummies, both could be any sort of other outcome variable that would require you to use nonlinear models in either one or both equations. So this really becomes very complicated, statistically speaking. Thankfully, recently, Stata does have options for you to estimate this. A few years ago, this would not have been possible in Stata. And specifically, we'll be using the GSEM command for this. We've seen SEM already, structural equations modeling, and GSEM means generalized structural equations modeling. And in the do file, you can see a whole overview of the different possibilities for the different equations. So what we see, for example, you can use a logit model in one of the equations. So in the options, you're going to either fill in logit or this whole piece here, family, Bernoulli, link, logit. Likewise, you could do a negative binomial regression in one of the equations, a Poisson, but also other things like probit, multinomial logit, ordinal logit, all different kinds of options. For this particular example, I'm going to show you how to take a dummy variable in the middle step, so in the mediating variable. So we're going to work similar to what we've done before. We're not going to use acquisitions, so the amount spent on acquisitions, but instead we're going to create a dummy variable that takes on the value of 1 when any money is spent on an acquisition. So we've done that already before, so I'm just going to run it here. And then the way the command is structured is as follows. We're going to specify the first equation, that's this whole block here. That's going to be cash on this dummy variable, any acquisition. And we're adding the option family Bernoulli link logit within these parentheses. So within this equation, we're going to specify that it's a logit or logistic regression model. This whole block could also be just replaced with logit, which is also what's shown up here. The second equation is simple, that's just a regular regression that we've seen already, with gross profits as the outcome, being explained by cash and by the mediating variable, any acquisition. The other options are the same as with the normal SEM command. So let's run this. It will take a little bit, but still quite fast. And then you get the two equations. The first one we see here, that's the logit model. That's this one here. Interpretation would be similar to this other, to the, just a regular old logit model that we've seen already. And this is the second stage. So this is the gross profits variable. Unfortunately, the estat tfx command doesn't work anymore. If we run this, it says it's not valid. So it's no longer this standard mediation model. If you want to get the indirect effect, the direct effects, etc., you're going to have to calculate this manually. In this case, because in the logit model, there is no longer one direct effect of cash on acquisitions. We've seen that it depends on the value of cash. Still, a way to do this in a kind of sensible and straightforward way is to calculate the average marginal effects. So let's do that first for cash. That's going to yield two estimates because cash is in both equations. You see here at the first row, this is the average marginal effect of cash on any acquisition outcome variable. So as cash goes up by one unit, the probability of acquiring goes up by this much. And in the direct effect, or the average direct effect of cash on gross profits is this much. So a 1 unit increase in cash increases gross profits directly by this much. We can also calculate the average marginal effect for any acquisition variable, which will only yield one estimate, because that's the effect of acquiring on gross profits. So a firm that acquires on average has a gross profits this much higher. And what this does is enable you to get some sense of what type of mediation there is. In this case, we see a significant effect of cash on the probability of acquiring, as well as a significant effect of acquiring on gross profits. So this would suggest that there is a significant indirect effect. And we also see a significant direct effect of cash on gross profits. So there's both a direct effect and there seems to be an indirect effect. So all in all, this would suggest that there is partial mediation. You can also bootstrap all this sort of stuff. You can just use the similar setup to what I had before. However, you cannot calculate the direct effect, indirect effects, etc. in this easy way, unfortunately. However, I would say that for a typical thesis, the information provided here should be sufficient. So you can still multiply this times this to get a sense of what the indirect effect is, and you can still interpret these significance levels similar to what we've seen before. That's all that I wanted to show for how to do mediation in nonlinear models. If you need to do this for your thesis, feel free to reach out and I'd be happy to look into it for you as well, because every specific model will be slightly different depending on what specific option you use. But nevertheless, the core logic that I've shown here should generalize to all these different possible combinations. That's all that I wanted to say for now, and actually this would be all that I have planned for videos for the quantitative methods course. So if you're still with me, thanks for watching all these videos. And please post any questions that you might have on the discussion board for the course. Thanks for watching.